Hello everyone, this is Rupesh. Today I'll be discussing about vitamins in Unit 4 of Paper Organic Chemistry 2. Vitamins. The term vitamin is derived from the word vitamin, which was coined by Polish biochemist Casimir Funk in 1912, who isolated a complex of micronutrients essential to life, all of which he presumed to be amines, which is vital, hence it is called vitamin. A vitamin is an organic molecule or related set of molecules that is an essential micronutrient which an organism needs in small quantities for the proper functioning of its metabolism. Essential nutrients cannot be synthesized in the organism either at all or not in sufficient quantities, and therefore must be obtained through the diet. There are totally 13 vitamins, out of which is divided into two categories, that is water soluble and fat soluble. Vitamin B and C are water soluble, whereas vitamin A, D, E and K are fat solubles. Coming to vitamin A, it is a group of unsaturated nutritional organic compounds that includes retinol, retinal and retinoic acid and several other provitamin A carotenoids. The name itself shows retinol, which has a hydroxy group, in retinol aldehyde, in retinoic acid it's a carboxylic acid group. Metabolic functions. Vitamin A plays a role in a variety of functions throughout the body, such as vision, helps in vision, gene transcription, immune function, embryonic development and reproduction, bone metabolism, hematopoiesis. Hematopoiesis is the formation of blood cellular components, and skin and cellular health, teeth, mucous membrane. And this is the structure of a vitamin A, and you can see the conjugated double bonds. And coming to the sources of vitamin A, cod liver oil, which is enriched in vitamin A, and liver of turkey, beef, pork, fish and chicken, all milk products such as cheese, butter, etc., sweet potato, broccoli leaf, carrot, spinach, pumpkin, collard greens, apricots, papaya, cantaloupe, melon, bell peppers, which is also called as capsicum, egg, tomatoes, mangoes, peas, broccoli florets, spirulina, and dry fruits. Coming to the synthesis, starts from citral, and in acidic media we get the cyclase, aldehyde. This on reacting with acetone in the presence of a base, we get and beta ionone. This is a beta ionone, and this reaction is called an aldol condensation. That is, a base abstracts proton here, it will become CH2-, which attacks a carbonyl group, the formation of CO. And this beta ionone on reacting with acetylene in sodium and ammonia, you get at this corresponding hydroxy group. This on reduction with hydrogen, palladium, barium sulfate in quinolin, this is called Lindlar's catalyst. Here barium sulfate is used to coat the palladium, whereas quinolin is used to poison the palladium so that the effect of palladium is decreased. Hence triple bond is reduced to double bond. If it is not poisoned, then triple bond and all the double bonds get reduced to single bond. And this alky on bromination using HBr, we get a corresponding bromo compound. This on reacting with PPH3, we get the corresponding phosphonium bromide salt. This on reacting with an aldehyde, as a subsequent addition of base as well as acidified water, we get and carboxylic acid. This we get a mixture of isomers, then we separate only a trans isomer, and then esterification using ethanol in acid COOH is converted to ethyl ester, which on reduction with lithium aluminium hydride, we get a vitamin A1, which is a retinol. Coming to the vitamin A2, and you can see a one more double bond here, which is extra compared to a vitamin A1. This starts from vitamin A1. This is vitamin A1. This on oxidation, we get an aldehyde, which is a retinal, since it is a aldehyde group. This on reacting with NBS, N-bromosuccinamide. This is used for the allylic bromination. This is the allylic carbon, hence it get brominated at this position. You get this corresponding brominated compound, brominated retinal one. This on treating with phenylmorpholine. This is a base which abstracts a proton here with the formation of a double bond and elimination of a bromide. We get a double bond here. This on reduction with LAH, lithium aluminium hydride, CHO, that is aldehyde, is converted to an alcohol, which is vitamin A2 retinol. Sorry, this is retinol, NOL. Coming to deficiency, prolonged deficiency causes inflammation of the eyes, poor vision, frequent colds, night blindness, lack of appetite and vigor, defects in teeth and gums, skin disorder. The lack of appetite and vigor. Vigor is the physical strength and good health. So it lacks physical strength and good health. Coming to the mechanism of vision, that is vitamin A1, they are all light sensitive molecules. In light, it converted to vitamin A1, nu B. This using a NADP+, it is converted to a cis retinal 1. That is, you can see a trans bond is converted to a cis bond here. This in a dark, in presence of opsin, it is converted to a cis retinylidine. This is a rhodopsin, which is a photosensitive molecule. This on photolight, that is photo, in the presence of light, it is get converted to a transretinal. And transretinal and cisretinal can be interconverted using light as well as enzyme. This transretinal on consuming NADP, DPH+, and it is converted to vitamin A1. Coming to the next vitamin, vitamin B1. Vitamin B1, as I told, it is a water-soluble vitamin. Vitamin B is also known as thiamine or thiamine. Enables the body to use carbohydrates as energy. It is essential for glucose metabolism and it plays a key role in nerve, muscle and heart function. And this is the structure of a thiamine, and you can see this is the pyrimidine and this is a thiazole ring. Source of vitamin B1, that is a wheat, it is also from wheat germ, yeast, outer layer of whole grains, cereals, pulses, nuts, peas, legumes, dark green leafy veggies, milk products, egg, banana, maple syrup is a good vitamin B1 source, and also apple. Deficiency causes serious impairment of the digestive system and chronic constipation, loss of weight, diabetes, mental depression, irritability, confusion, nervous exhaustion and weakness of heart. Coming to synthesis, synthesis is divided into two parts. It starts from the malonic acid derivative, that is only one carboxylic acid is protected with ethyl group. This on treating with chlorinating agents, it is converted to an acid chloride. There are many chlorinating agents such as PCl5, POCl3, that is phosphorus oxychloride, as well as phosgene, which is COCl2. It is converted to an acid chloride. This on using Lindlar's catalyst, as I said, the role of barium sulfate and quinoline. which reduces COCl to aldehyde. This aldehyde on reduction using sodium borohydride, it is converted to a primary alcohol. This on reacting with base, you get O minus. This O minus on treatment with ethyl iodide, it attacks an ethyl group with the elimination of iodide. You get OET. This on reacting with ethyl formate in the presence of sodium in ethanol, you get the corresponding aldehyde. Here ethyl formate is a good formulating agent. This is an aldehyde, hence it is a formulating agent. This on reacting with methyl amidine, this moiety is called an amidine. Here there is a methyl group, hence it is a methyl amidine in the presence of a base. This is condensed with this molecule. It gets adds up across this molecule to form a pyrimidine derived molecule. This on chlorination using PCl5 or PCl3, it gets chlorinated here and hydroxyl group eliminated. This on ammonolysis, reacting with ammonia, NH2 is inserted here and chloride groups is eliminated. This ammonia on treatment with 48% HBr, we get an pyrimidine derived bromide salt, which is a stable one. This is a part A. Coming to the synthesis of part B, starts with ethyl acetate. Reacts with this bromide compound in the presence of base. This base abstracts a proton here, forms C minus, which attacks here with the elimination of a bromide ion to form this. This on chlorination using thionyl chloride, it gets chlorinated here. This on acidification and correspondingly it gets reflexed. On acidification, ester is converted to a carboxylic acid. On heating, carbon dioxide is eliminated to form the corresponding compound. This on reacting with thioformaldehyde, we get an thiazole derived ring, thiazole derived molecule. This on chlorination using HCl, OET is eliminated and chloride gets attached. This on boiling in water, we get an hydroxy group. This is a part B. This is reacted with the part A, which is synthesized in the previous scheme. We get an bromide salt, which is a thiamine with a bromide salt. This on reacting with a silver chloride in methanol, we get a chloride salt, which is stable compared to a bromide salt. And this is the synthesis of vitamin B1, which is thiamine. Coming to the next vitamin B2, riboflavin, also known as vitamin B2, is a vitamin found in food and used as a dietary supplement, essential for growth and general health, for healthy eyes, skin, nails and hair, helps to eliminate sore mouth, lips and tongue, metabolizes carbohydrates, fats and protein. It is useful in the treatment of nutritional cataract and other eye ailments, digestive disturbances and nervous depression. This is the structure of a vitamin B2, and you can see this part is an D-ribose and this part is an isoalloxazine. Coming to the sources of vitamin B2, green leafy veggies are highly enriched with vitamin B2, milk, egg, cheese, almonds, sunflower seeds, citrus fruits and tomatoes. Deficiency, riboflavin deficiency, also called riboflavinosis, results in stomatitis, including painful red tongue with sore throat, chapped and fissured lips, which is also called as chelosis, and inflammation of the corners of the mouth, which is called angular stomatitis. There can be oily, scaly skin, rashes on the scrotum, vulva, philtrum of the lip or the nasolabial folds. The eyes can become itchy, watery, bloodshot and sensitive to light. Deficiency of riboflavin during pregnancy can result in birth defects including congenital heart defects and limb deformities. Prolonged riboflavin insufficiency is also known to cause degeneration of the liver and nervous system. Coming to synthesis, this is an amino xylene reacts with is a D-glucose to form an imine. This on reduction using H2 palladium, we get a secondary amine. This on reacting with a diazo compound, we get a corresponding azo, which is also azo derived compound. This on reduction with H2 nickel is a Renin nickel. It gets reduced here with the elimination of nitroaniline. We get this one. This on condensing with, this is an alloxane. This molecule is called an alloxane. Condensing with this, we get a corresponding vitamin B2, which is a riboflavin. Coming to next vitamin, vitamin B5. Pantothenic acid, also known as vitamin B5, is a water-soluble vitamin. It is an essential nutrient. Animals require pantothenic acid in order to synthesize coenzyme A as well as to synthesize and metabolize proteins, carbohydrates and fats. Helps in cell building, maintaining normal growth and development of the central nervous system. Stimulates adrenal glands and increases the production of cortisone. Coming to biological functions, only the D isomer of the pantothenic acid possesses biological activity, whereas L form may antagonize the effects of the dextrorotatory isomer. Pantothenic acid in the form of coenzyme A is also required for the acylation as well as acetylation, which for example are involved in signal transduction and various enzyme functions. And this is a vitamin B5, the structure of pantothenic acid, and you can see there is an amide moiety, and this is formed using an beta alanine. This is a rare amino acid, which is beta alanine. Main sources: dried shiitake mushrooms, liver, kidney, egg yolks, sunflower seeds, alfalfa, cereal, fish meal, peanut meal, molasses, which is from sugarcane, and mushrooms, rice, wheat bran, and yeast. Deficiency causes headache, chronic fatigue, irritability, impaired muscle coordination, gastrointestinal problems. Synthesis starts with isopropanolide reacts with formaldehyde in the presence of a base. That is, base abstracts a proton here. This C minus comes and attacks with the formation of an OH. This gives a CH2OH. This on reacting with KCN, we get a cyanohydrine. This is a cyanohydrine group. This on oxidation using HCl in water, a cyano group oxidizes to an carboxylic acid. This in turn it is converted to a pentalactone, that is a lone pair on oxygen to form a double bond here, and this double bond attacks this carbon with the elimination of an hydroxy group to form a lactone ring, which is a pentalactone. And pentalactone reacts with this. As I said, this is a beta alanine, C protected, that is ethyl protected beta alanine, to form an corresponding ester. This on treating with barium hydroxide, we get pantothenic acid. Barium hydroxide occasionally used as a strong base for the hydrolysis of esters. That is, ester can be converted to an corresponding carboxylic acid. Coming to the next vitamin, it's vitamin B6, pyridoxine, also known as vitamin B6, found commonly in food and used as a dietary supplement. It is required by the body to make amino acids, carbohydrates and lipids. Sources in the diet include fruit, vegetables and grain. It is also required for muscle phosphorylase activity associated with glycogen metabolism. It is used to treat hyperactivity in children, asthma, arthritis, kidney stone and blood clot. Deficiency causes dermatitis, which is a skin inflammation, and conjunctivitis. Conjunctivitis is an inflammation or infection of the outer membrane of the eyeball and the inner eyelid, and anemia, iron deficient, and depression, insomnia, and nervousness. This is the structure of an pyridoxine. This is pyridoxal. You can see that primary alcohol is converted to an aldehyde. Pyridoxal amine, that instead of alcohol, there is an amine group. Synthesis starts with ethoxyacetyl acetone. That is ethoxy, and this is acetyl, and this is acetone. Reacts with this cyanoacetamide. This is an acetamide, and cyano is substituted in cyanoacetamide. In the presence of pyridine in ethanol, you get the corresponding compound. This on nitration, it gets nitrated in this position. This, the corresponding nitro compound, on reacting with PCl5, which is a chlorinating as well as a good dehydrating agent, we get a double bond, as well as it gets chlorinated in this position. This on reduction using hydrogen and palladium carbon, we get a cyano group is converted to an amine, as well as nitro is converted to an amine. This on reacting with HNO2, we get, it is amines are converted to an corresponding alcohol, we get a diol. This on you reacting with 40% HBr, only primary alcohol and ether gets converted to a bromide, but the hydroxy group, which is attached to sp2 carbon, is unaffected. The corresponding dimbromide reacts with HgCl to form an primary alcohol, which is a pyridoxal. Interconversion of pyridoxine, pyridoxal amine, and pyridoxal. That is, pyridoxine can be converted to pyridoxal on oxidation using manganese oxide in acidic medium. That is, primary alcohol, only this alcohol gets converted to aldehyde. In fact, even pyridoxal can be converted to pyridoxine on reduction using sodium borohydride, and pyridoxal can be converted to pyridoxal amine using hydroxyl amine. You get an imine, that is hydroxyl imine. This on reduction using H2 nica pyridoxal amine. In fact, even this pyridoxal amine can be converted to a pyridoxine using HNO2 or else HNO3, and corresponding reduction we get pyridoxine. Coming to next vitamin, vitamin B9, folate, also known as vitamin B9 and folacin, is one of the vitamin B. Manufactured folic acid, which is converted into folate by the body, is used as a dietary supplement and in food fortification, as it is more stable during processing and storage. Folate is required for the body to make DNA and RNA to metabolize amino acids necessary for cell division. As humans cannot make folate, it is required in the diet, making it an essential vitamin. This is the structure of a vitamin B9, that is folic acid. You can see this group is called a pteridin, P-T-E-R-I-D-I-N, pteridin, and this is and para amino benzoic acid derivative, and this is an amino acid which is a glutamic acid. It is a combination of three molecules. Coming to deficiency, folate deficiency hinders DNA synthesis and cell division, affecting hematopoietic cells and neoplasms the most because of their greater frequency of cell division. Coming to the synthesis, starts from urea and aminolysis using ammonia, that is reacting with ammonia. You get an guanidine. This is a guanidine molecule. Reacts with the cyanoester, that is cyano group. That is condensing with the condensing these two molecules, we get a corresponding imine, which is in on tautomerization, we get a corresponding pyrimidine derived molecule. This on nitration, this on oxidation using HNO2, we get this nitro compound. This on catalytic hydrogenation, nitro is converted to an amine. This on reacting with this dibromoaldehyde, it is synthesized using acrolein. Acrolein on reaction with bromine, we get this aldehyde. These two condenses to form a pteridyl bromide. This is a pteridyl bromide. This pteridyl bromide reacts with this molecule, which is a amidation of para-amino benzoic acid as well as glutamic acid. We get an corresponding folic acid. That is, this amino group comes and attacks here with the elimination of a bromine. And these two molecules can be synthesized using a simple procedure using DCC-HOBT method. That is, para-amino benzoic acid using DCC-HOBT treated with this glutamic acid. Coming to the next important vitamin, it is vitamin C, also known as ascorbic acid and ascorbate, is a vitamin found in various foods and sold as a dietary supplement. Vitamin C is an essential nutrient involved in the repair of tissue and the enzymatic production of certain neurotransmitters. It is required for the functioning of several enzymes and is important for immune system function. It also functions as an antioxidant. As well as vitamin C is a very good free radical scavengers. It removes the free radicals in our body. And there is some evidence that regular use of supplements may reduce the duration of the common cold, but does not appear to prevent the infection. And it helps in decreasing the blood cholesterol, cures common cold, increases sexual vitality. There is a structure of a vitamin C, that is a structure of ascorbic acid. Coming to the deficiency, causes serious disease, which is scurvy, anemia, bleeding gums, slow healing of wounds, premature aging, and lowered resistance to all types of infections. Synthesis starts from D-glucose, which on reacting with hydrogen renin nickel, we get a corresponding primary alcohol, that is aldehyde is converted to an alcohol, and it is in fact treated with acetobacter suboxidants. The name itself indicates acetobacter is a genus of acetic acid bacteria, whereas acetobacter suboxidants is known to bring about oxidation of polyhydroxy compounds. That is, the pH should be maintained at very low, because the name itself indicates there is acetic acid and the reaction is run at 30 to 35 degree Celsius. That is, this hydroxy group is oxidized to carbonyl. This on reacting with acetone and sulfuric acid, you get a tricyclic ring. This on reacting with sodium hypochlorite in nickel chloride, and subsequent reacting with acidified water, we get corresponding keto acids. This is a keto acid. This on reacting with HCl and refluxing in toluene, you get a cyclized product, which is ascorbic acid. Coming to the next vitamin, vitamin E, alpha tocopherol. Alpha tocopherol is a type of vitamin E. It exists in 8 different forms. 4 are tocopherols and 4 are tocotrienols. Many biological functions have been postulated, including a role as a fat-soluble antioxidant. As vitamin E is a fat-soluble vitamin. As it is a fat-soluble, vitamin E is incorporated into cell membranes, which are therefore protected from oxidative damage. Vitamin E affects gene expression and is an enzyme activity regulator, such as for protein kinase C, which plays a role in smooth muscle growth. With vitamin E participating in deactivation of PKC to inhibit smooth muscle growth. It prevents unsaturated fatty acids, sex hormones, and fat-soluble vitamins from being destroyed in the body by oxidation. It dilates blood vessels and improves blood circulation, essential for prevention of heart disease, asthma, and arthritis. And you can see this is the structure of an vitamin E. Coming to the synthesis, synthesis starts from farnesol. This is a farnesol molecule. It is an acyclic sesquiterpene alcohol. This on reduction with hydrogen palladium carbon, all the double bond gets reduced to a single bond. This alcohol and bromination using PBr3, it gets brominated. This on reacting with ethyl acetoacetate as well as base abstracts a proton here, it forms C minus comes and attacks here with the elimination of bromide. We get the corresponding ester, that is keto ester. Keto ester and reacting with base, that is KOH, it is converted to carboxylic acid, and in turn it loses a carbon dioxide molecule, and subsequent acidification we get a corresponding ketone. This on reacting with acetylene in presence of soda amide abstracts a proton here, which forms acetylene carbanion C minus. This attacks here with the carbonyl group, and this bond shifts and which takes a proton to form an alcohol as well as an acetylene. This on reduction using Lindlar's catalyst, that is triple bond is reduced to a double bond. This on reacting with acetic anhydride, you get a corresponding allyl alcohol. This is on reacting with acetic anhydride, OH is converted to an OAC, that is acetyl group. This bond shifts here, and OAC is eliminated, and the eliminated OAC comes and attacks here, which was a carbocation, and a OAC, further OAC is hydrolyzed, that is acid hydrolyzed. We get a allyl alcohol. This is also called as phylol, PHYLOL. This on bromination using PBr3, we get a corresponding bromide, which is phylol bromide. This on reacting with this is trimethyl substituted quinol. On reacting with this bromo compound in the presence of zinc chloride, we get this one, that is this triple bond, this pi electrons, pi bond attacks here, the elimination of bromo compound, we get this one, and losing a proton here, the aromatic compound is regained, and the lone pair of electrons which attacks here, and this double bond takes a proton to form a cyclic compound, which is a corresponding vitamin. That is tocopherol. And coming to the vitamin H or B7, biotin, also called vitamin H or vitamin B7 or vitamin B8, is a water soluble vitamin. All vitamin B derivatives are, all vitamin B categories are all water soluble. Biotin is involved in a wide range of metabolic processes, both in humans and in other organisms, primarily related to the utilization of fats, carbohydrates, and amino acids. Biotin is important in fatty acid synthesis, branch chain amino acid catabolism, and gluconeogenesis. It covalently attaches to the epsilon amino group of specific lysine residues in this carboxylases. Deficiency. Symptoms include brittle and thin fingernails, hair loss, which is also called as alopecia, conjunctivitis, as I said, it is an eye infection, dermatitis in the form of a scaly red rash around the eyes, nose, mouth, and genital area. Neurological symptoms in adults such as depression, lethargy, hallucination, and numbness, and tingling of the extremities, that is prickling effect. Symptoms like depression and lack of interest are indications that your biotin levels are very low. Coming to the synthesis, starts from cysteine. This is a cysteine amino acid, and reacting with the base, it gets a thiolate. This is a salt. This on reacting with this chloro compound, this thiolate attacks here with the elimination of a chloride ion. We get a disodium salt of carboxylic acid. This on reacting with acidified water, you get a corresponding diacid. This on reacting with benzoyl chloride with the corresponding amide, which is also a N type of protection, where N is protected here using benzoyl group. This on esterification using methanol in acid, you get the corresponding methyl esters. This on reacting with sodium methoxide in methanol. Sodium methoxide is a base which abstracts proton here. This attacks the carbonyl group with the elimination of an OMe to form a corresponding cyclic, which is a tetrahydrothiophene molecule, where this step is a Dieckmann cyclization reaction. This on corresponding reaction where this on treating with HCl, we get corresponding acid. This on losing a decarboxylation, that is carbon dioxide is eliminated, and subsequent acidification, we get a COOH is eliminated, you get a simple keto compound. This on reacting with aldehyde, we get an alkene. This on reacting with ammonium hydroxide, that is keto is converted to an hydroxyl amine, that is an imine. This hydroxyl amine is in fact reduced using zinc in acetic acid to the corresponding acetamide. This on reduction using hydrogen in palladium carbon, double bond gets reduced here, and this corresponding compound on reacting with this barium hydroxide, as I said, is occasionally used strong base. It is converted to a COOH, as well as this on acidification, we get an NH2, and this is also primary amide. That is, an amide bond is broken here. This on further chlorination acylation using phosgene. This is phosgene. It gets acylated to the both amine, and this sodium carbonate is used to quench the HCl soap generated in the reaction and to get a biotin in good yields. Coming to the next vitamin, vitamin K1 and K2, which is the last vitamin. Vitamin K, the generic name for a family of compounds with a common chemical structure of 2-methyl-1,4-naphthoquinone, is a fat-soluble vitamin that is naturally present in some foods and is available as a dietary supplement. These compounds include phylloquinone, which is a vitamin K1, and a series of menaquinones, vitamin K2. This vitamin K2 have unsaturated isoprenyl side chains, and you can see there is a structure of a vitamin K1 and there is a structure of a vitamin K2. As I said, vitamin K2 has a unsaturated isoprenyl side chains, and there is a two types of vitamin K2 which has a carbon 20 in the side chain as well as 35 in the side chains. Sources: vitamin K1 is found chiefly in leafy green vegetables such as spinach, Swiss chard, lettuce, and brassica vegetables such as cabbage, kale, cauliflower, broccoli, and Brussels sprouts. And often the absorption is greater when accompanied by fats such as butter or oils. Some fruits such as avocados, kiwi fruit, and grapes also contain vitamin K. Coming to synthesis, starts from farnesol. It is as before as tocopherol. This farnesol on reduction using hydrogen and palladium, all double bond gets reduced to a single bond. We get a primary alcohol. This on bromination using PBr3, we get a corresponding bromide, bromine compound. This on reacting with ethyl ester acetate in presence of base, it gets carbene ion. This attacks here, the elimination of bromide, we get a corresponding keto ester. This on reacting with KOH, it gets converted to acid, and subsequent elimination of COO2 and subsequent acidification, we get a keto compound. This on reacting with acetylene in the presence of sodamide and subsequent acidification, we get this hydroxyacetylene. This is reduced, this triple bond is reduced using Lindlar's catalyst to an alkene. This on reacting with acetic anhydride and subsequent acidification, we get an allylic alcohol. This on reacting with is an methyl naphthoquinone. In the presence of oxalic acid, we get the corresponding compound. This on reacting with silver oxide, we get an vitamin K1. That is, using silver oxide, lone pair on oxygen forms a double bond. This double bond shifts here and this double bond shifts to form a quinone. This is a quinone moiety, which is K1, vitamin K1. Coming to deficiency, symptoms of K1 deficiency include anemia, bruising, nosebleeds, and bleeding of the gums, and heavy menstrual bleeding in women. Osteoporosis and coronary heart disease are strongly associated with lower levels of K2, which is a menaquinone. Coming to the synthesis of K2, that is, it which has a 35 carbons in the side chain, it starts from the methyl naphthoquinone, reacts with this alcohol, the presence of a catalytic acid, we get the corresponding vitamin K2, which has a 35 carbons here and not the 20 which I shown in the previous slide. There is a synthesis of vitamin K2, and this is all about vitamins. Thank you for your attention.